massage therapist who accused Kevin Spacey is dead. The deceased accused Spacey of sexually assaulting him during a session in October 2016. No further information was disclosed, but the anonymous massage therapist filed suit in September 2018, alleging that Spacey had forced him to grab his genitals and try to kiss him during a session in Malibu. Spacey's attorney filed a notice in the federal court on Tuesday, stating that the plaintiff's attorney notified him of the death on September 11. Kevin, Spacey. Let me just call him Spacey. I think I prefer calling him Spacey.
Guy now.
Yeah, the way he comes out of his case is usually questionable. Look. Like, you won't be able to fully rejoice because
House of Cards is about actually. Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, it came to my mind, like, this is just real life House of Cards, mm-hmm. but I don't know how to feel about it. But I don't know if I'm allowed to say I'm happy for him, but.
You say somebody's dead. There are people that are dead.
No,
but don't cut for cases.
The case is going to be dropped somehow. Like,
No. They have about 14 days for the estate of the dead person to come forward as the representative.
But you know, he's been anonymous. He's been John Doe.
Yeah, he's been John Doe all the while. So if his family decides to come out and say, "Oh yeah, we are the family of John Doe."
But I don't think they'll win the case, even if they come forward to
continue
the case.
Actually, you know that. You're not a law enforcement agent.
I'm not saying it's a certain that they will not. I just said I don't think. I personally don't think.
Yeah, but I believe, maybe because I personally think the law works, especially out there.
But the law works based on the evidences and the witnesses you place.
I mean, the only witness in this case is dead.
But this is a John Doe case that we have not even been abreast with the case because it's a John Doe. So they're not going to give you the other information like Rap, who accused Kevin Spacey in the past, and the case was thrown out. I don't even know about the actor Rap, the young actor that said Kevin also groped him in some very inappropriate manner. So if these people actually have evidences, they have footages, so it's not right for us to start saying the case will be thrown out. I'm asking that in 14 days, if the estates do not file, maybe the case will be thrown out. But let's wait for 14 days.
But what if 14 days does not stop the fact that
if
the proceedings of the case so far has not shown any positivity, at the end of the day, even if you are John Doe,
this person has been a John Doe.
Even if you are John Doe or whatever you want to call yourself, what it stops is your identity. It's not put out there. It doesn't stop the facts and whatever that is happening in the case. They don't hide
we
that.
We just don't know
You don't know who the person is. On. It's just like the case of Chris Brown and the rape case that was happening. But most people knew the beginning and the end of the case. The only thing is that we don't know who this lady is. So
this is not a lady. This is a man.
For Chris, it's a lady now. It's Chris' case, not a lady.
Ife, nobody's saying that case is 100% going to be dismissed, do you get? But what we're saying is that if they pursue that case, the chances of them winning is very, very
low. How do you know that? This is a John Doe case. You don't even know a thing
Ife,
about
why are you
case?
Making the John Doe case look like there's a particular John Doe story?
When it's a John Doe case, you're not supposed to know the process. You're not supposed to know anything about
the
case.
No, you just are not supposed to know the identity, that's all.
You're not supposed to know the identity.
That's all.
They're not going to reveal certain information about the case. Some things became clear to me about this John Doe. I knew about this John Doe case since 2017, since the case was filed, but I did not know certain things about him.
Was
saying
it filed in 2017 or 2018?
It was filed in 2017.
Okay.
Yeah. So I didn't know anything about the groping and forceful kissing and all of that, which I just knew it was sexual harassment and sexual assault and all of that.
He's always been groping kids from day one.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, you didn't know that part.
Okay, fine.
Which is why on this table, we've talked about him having, I remember Ife Omai was saying he has so many. When we were talking about the phone case, that one is gone, and where we just, and he has so many that it's looking like, okay, you probably did one or two of these cases. It's not just one, right? But anyways, we'll see how this plays out. And may the dead rest in peace, basically.
I think they should just allow that man rest in peace.
Whatever they should allow him rest in peace without justice. Like, what are we saying on this table?
Ife, I said they should allow the man rest in peace.
The John Doe.
Yes.
Without getting justice, even though he's dead.
But you know that this John Doe, he might actually be lying.
Well, he might actually be lying. So let the court, let the law take
it. But you're acting like you already know the truth and the beginning
and
end of the case.
We're not saying the court should throw this case away.
Like children.
That's what we're saying.
That's what exactly
no,
what
that's saying. What you're hearing. That's not what anybody on this table is saying.
All right, cool, man. All right.